Insecurity be fair to me, I'm not doing badly, Buhari begs Nigerians. President Muhammadu Buhari has urged Nigerians to be fair to his administration. Buhari made the remark while frowning at those accusing him of double standards with regards to pampering bandits and terrorists in the north, while going hard on the southern part of the country. Speaking on Nigeria Television Authority, NTA, the president said those accusing him of double standard are being unfair. The president insisted that his administration has not performed badly. According to Buhari, well, I want Nigerians to be fair to this administration. They should reflect seriously on the time we came in, especially as far as the northeast and the south is concerned. Where we are now, resources, how much we are producing. The previous administrations before me was producing 2.1 million per day at $100 per barrel. When we came in, militants in the South were unleashed on this administration and production went down to 500,000 barrel per day. And then in the market, oil price collapse. I would like Nigerians to reflect on this in terms of resources, in time, and I believe that we have not done very badly. Well, the area where President Muhammadu Buhari has done badly is the area of killing the citizens of Nigeria, and he has not one day consoled or taken any action to stop those who are killing people. Do you know that killing is not taking place in the northern part of Nigeria? And killing is taking place in the southern part of Nigeria, southeast and south-south, even southwest. And President Muhammadu Buhari has not voiced out one day. And who are those that are doing the killing? They are the Fulani herdsmen. And Fulani herdsmen, who send them out to be killing people? President Muhammadu Buhari. His government has issued out AK-47 to Fulani herdsmen who are moving on the land with their animals. Now, what does Fulani herdsmen are doing with AK-47? Now, if ordinarily the Fulani herdsmen are looking for food for their animal, then why are they carrying dangerous weapon all along with them? And when they get to anybody's farm, their animals eat up the crops. And if the owner comes out to intervene, they will gun the owner down. You know, so many Fulani herdsmen have surrendered so many women in the southeast, in the southwest, so many women widows, and so many men widowers, so many children orphans, and what have you. So many things are destroyed. And when investigation is carried out, you will discover that they are Fulani herdsmen. And people begin to wonder, how do they came about with the AK-47? So in Nigeria today, there is no Fulani herdsmen that does not have AK-47 with them. They have been killing in Benue State, and it has extended to many parts of Nigeria. Now, why does President Muhammadu Buhari does not stop the Fulani herdsmen from killing? So it is not even an alleged, It is his government that sent them out so that he can by then take over Nigeria. Then if Fulani herdsmen has sweep people everywhere, and if anybody touch them, he will release army to go against those people. That is the activities that is going on in Nigeria. So there is no doubt about that. So killings that has been happening in Nigeria that President Muhammad Buhari keep quiet, that is a very bad attitude. Do you know how many Nigeria has lost their life, lost farm as a result of Fulani herdsmen? Today, people can no longer go to farm. People can no longer go to market. People can no longer go about their working. And his administration has not provided any job for anybody. The place where people are working to be able to live with them and their family, Fulani herdsmen has destroyed everything. Today, you cannot go to the market and buy anything. Food stuff is so costly. I think food stuff is now times four of what it used to be before. Now you are here talking about oil. We are not talking about what happened to the oil. Now, what happened to the people that you came to lead? What is happening to them? Why have you kept quiet about those that has been killing? Why you kept quiet about the blood that has been shed in Nigeria? Why is it that you take things so hard upon the southeast, southwest, and south south, but to the north, the Fulani and Hausa, you take things lightly with them? You have not questioning them. You have not done anything to them. I mean, there is no violence in the northern part, except maybe in Borno State and part of Yobe and Niger, and that, even that one we are talking about, there are the Boko Harams who has been terrorizing this area. But the area where we are talking about is the southeast, where lately you deploy security operative to go there and get the people down. And today they have killed a score of people. That is why you see that government rose up in that place and they started destroying the government properties in that area. So everything that happened in Nigeria today, you cause it. I'm not saying that you are the causes of insecurity. There are insecurity before you came, but it seems that since you came, everything became worse. Everything has gone up. So many bad activities has happened in the country, which you did not speak anything about it. You only speak when Fulani herdsmen are touched. So I think that is sentiment and bias in your government. So right now, what you are talking is out of proportion, and nobody is going to listen to you. It's like you love secessionists, and I think that will take place.